what he has given here. So given is F is equal to 10 for 90 kilonewton, sigma and sigma naught I need to find. So here first we need to find, step one is what? To find x dash. So we have from the data handbook, you can see clearly here. So from the data handbook, so here we have a trapezoidal cross section. So here we have the B naught by 2. So this half and this half becomes B naught. This total distance is B naught. Means what? If I consider this larger distance as B1, B1 minus B gives me what? B naught value. Okay. So here we have the X dash formula. 3B plus 2B naught by H by 3, 2B plus B naught, where H is the depth of the cross section. Fine. So okay. So that I will specify the table number, everything there. So here, from table 1.3A, figure number F, page 13 from data handbook. Fine. So we have C. C is from the data handbook. So we need X dash. So I will call it as a X dash. So this is what 3B naught. So 3B plus 2B naught H whole divided by 3 2B plus B naught. Fine. So now, so we shall specify the notations here. So here I have, this is the trapezoidal cross section what I have. So this is 25 mm, this is 87.5 mm, total depth is 112.5 mm. Okay, so now I have B is equal to 25 mm. So how can I find the B naught? So B1 is what? 87.5 mm, and H is 112.5 mm. So how can I find the B naught there? So I said you, so B naught is equal to B1 minus B. So this is the distance, half of distance 1. If I subtract this minus this, I'll get this B half of value. That is what B value I'll get. So B naught, B1 plus minus B, 87.5 mm plus 25, sorry, it is minus 25 mm. That gives me B naught is equal to 62.5 mm. So now directly I'm going to substitute this values in the X dash. So X dash is equal to 3 into 25 plus 2 into 62.5 into 112.5 whole divided by 3 into 2 into 25 plus 62.5. So finally I got X dash value as 45.83 mm. Fine. So what will be the second step? So second step, I need to replace the given eccentric load or eccentric force by an equal and parallel force through CG along with a couple. So now what I am going to do here, so here I am going, here the load is applied at the center, eccentric load. Now I am going to replace that as a couple force at this equal and parallel at this distance. Okay, I will consider only this quarter part here. So if I draw the diagram and when I want to replace, so I can draw only the quarter part there. So here is the application of load, 90 kilonewton, and here I am going to replace through CG a couple force of 90 kilonewton. So this is what step 2. Okay, so now step 3. Step 3, to find what? Direct stresses. Okay. So to find direct stresses. Fine. So here I need to find direct sigma. I know sigma is equal to force by area. So how to find the area? So we know it is a regular geometry of a trapezoidal. We know area A is equal to h by 2 b1 plus b. So this is a formula for the regular geometry of the trapezoidal. So A will be 112.5 divided by 2, b0 is 87.5 plus 25. So area will be 6,328.13 mm square. So this is what area I have got. Okay, fine. So now I can find the stress. Sigma is equal to, so I know the load there. Load is 90 kilonewton. Area I know 6,328.13. So this implies I know this. I got the stresses. Sigma is equal to direct stresses 14.22 newton per mm square. Okay, fine. So now I'll go for the next step. So before I go to the next step, I am going to draw the diagram there. So from the diagram, I need to identify C1, C2, Ci and C0, all the values where I need to find the bending stresses. Okay. So here I have the trapezoidal shape. Okay. So here this is a section part. What I have is given. So here CG, so centroidal axis, I'll draw centroidal axis somewhere here and I'll draw the neutral axis. So where the neutral axis should be drawn? Neutral axis should be drawn near to the radius of curvature. In this problem, the radius of curvature and application of load both are on the same line. Okay, so this is load 90 kilonewton. At the same time, this is what? Radius of curvature. But in the previous problem, it is not so. The load is somewhere acting at a distance of 900 from the radius of curvature. But in this case, both are same. So where this load, so how it is useful means when the load is shifted or when the load is on the same radius of curvature, what is the difference that I will say here? Okay, so here we call a distance x. So x distance will be, this is centroidal axis, this is neutral axis. So distance x will be always from the load to the centroidal axis. X is the distance from applied load to the centroidal axis. This is very, very important. But in our case, here the distance is this. But in the previous case, we have to add 900 here. The load was acting at a distance of 900. You can observe here. Once again, I'll show the previous problem. When you go to the previous problem, here you can see where the distance is x is from the load to the centroidal axis. So here in the present problem, we have the radius of curvature and load at the same point. So here you can observe. So this is the distance x. Okay, this is very, very important. So this is what? Distance x. Fine. So now we shall specify all the notations here. So here we have the four radiuses. One radius from the radius of curvature to the inner fiber is ri. From the radius of curvature to the neutral axis, it is rn. From the radius of curvature to the centroidal axis, it is capital R. From the outer fiber to the radius of curvature, it is R naught. Fine. Okay. Now, from the inner fiber, this is inner fiber, this is outer fiber. This is called outer fiber. This is
inner fiber.
Okay, so from the inner fiber to the centroidal axis, from the inner fiber to the centroidal axis, the distance I'll call it as a C1. From the outer fiber to the centroidal axis, it is C2. Okay, same way for the neutral axis. From the inner fiber to the neutral axis is what? Ci. From the outer fiber to the neutral axis is what? C0. Okay, so these all the notations what we have to specify. Okay, so here we got x dash value, am I right? So in this case x dash is equal to C1. So x dash is also a distance from the inner fiber to the centroidal axis, that is what? C1. So what we have got C1 here? 45.83 mm we have got. So can we find C2? Yes, we can find C2 easily. We know what is the total depth. What is the total depth? It is h. So can I find C2 here? Total depth h minus C1, isn't it? H minus C1 gives me what? C2. So here h minus C1. So that is nothing but 112.5 minus 45.83 gives me what? C2. So C2 will be 66.67 mm. So what about the x distance? So x is what? Distance from the applied load to the centroidal axis. Can I know Ri? So Ri is from the given itself. So here you can see Ri from the given problem, this is what Ri. Am I right? So from the centroidal axis to the inner fiber is given R is 62.5. Fine. Okay. So Ri will be 62.5. So can I find x? So x Ri plus x C1. Can you see here? Inner fiber to the centroidal axis distance is C1, am I right? So with that, if I add this Ri, I will get what? X distance. So X will be Ri plus C1, am I right? So what will be the X here? X is equal to, I know the Ri value there. X is equal to 62.5 plus 45.8. 83. So this is what? X distance. Okay. And next, what can I find? I can find R0 here. I can find R0. I can find R. Am I right? How can I find R? R and X both are same here. So R is equal to X. Am I right? So R and X both are same here. That is equal to 108.33 mm. Once again, I am saying in this case, R is equal to X, but if the application of load is away from the radius of curvature, then R won't be equal to X. It varies. Okay, but in this problem only the R is equal to X. Okay, fine. So now what will be the R0 distance here? So R0 is equal to Ri plus H. Am I right? This is Ri and this is the total depth. Can I find H? This is H plus Ri. Okay. So this is equal to R0, I got 175 mm. So I need only the three things I have left with: Rn value, C0 value and Ci value. So these things, to find these things, I need a distance. So here one more thing I have forgot. So distance between centroidal axis and neutral axis, it is E, eccentricity. So distance between centroidal axis and neutral axis is E. So I need to find E. Once I find E, I can find easily C0, Ci and Rn. Okay, fine. So now we shall go for the step 4. So we have solved the step 3. So direct stresses we have solved. Now we shall go for the step 4. So here I have step 4 to find the bending stresses sigma I and sigma naught. So here in this first case, I need to find the moment. So moment is what? M force into distance x. So x already we have found. Or also I can write F, x is what? Ri plus C1. If I substitute, m is equal to 90, 10 raised to 3, Ri 62.5, C1 45.83. So m will be 9.75 into 10 raised to 6 Newton mm. Okay, so now I can find, so now I have found the moment. So now I need to find what? Eccentricity E. E, Rn, Ci and C0 I need to find. So to find E, so second case, so from the data handbook, page number 163. So I'll show you the data handbook here. If we remove page number 163, table number 10.1, so we have the trapezoidal section. Here you can see E is equal to R minus Rn. So even he has given the Rn formula here. So where Rn is equal to A by A is the area by B1 R plus C2 minus B R minus C1 by H ln R plus C2 by R minus C1 minus B1 minus B2, B1 minus B. So I know the R value, I know C1, C2 value, H value, B value and B1 value. I can find easily the E. So here I will get Rn value directly from the data handbook. Here I can substitute R minus Rn, I will get E. So directly I will substitute E value here. Fine. Okay. So now I got, I'll write the table number, all those things. So here from table 10.1 figure number 7 page 163 from data handbook, I have what? E is equal to R minus Rn. Okay, so E is equal to R minus Rn. So what will be that? R minus A whole divided by, so B1 R plus C2 minus B R minus C1 whole divided by H into ln R plus C2 by R minus C1. Okay, total, I'll close the flower bracket, minus B1 minus B. So this is the formula I have from the data handbook. Okay, fine. So now I'm going to substitute all those values. Okay, so here I'm going to substitute here one by one. So E is equal to 108.33 minus area 6328.13 whole divided by, okay, 87.5 into 108.33 plus 66.67 minus B is 25, R is again 108.33 plus 45.83, close the bracket, whole divided by depth 112.5. So this is a close bracket. Again I have a ln 108.33 plus 66.67 whole divided by 108.33 minus 45.83. So this I will close with a what? Square bracket minus, so B1 minus B, 87.5 minus 25. So if I substitute all the values, I'll get E value. I'll get E as
E is equal to 8.43 mm. Fine. So now I can find easily what? Ci and C naught. So here how can I find Ci here? C1 minus E. This total C1 minus E gives me Ci. So in this C1, if I remove E value, I'll get Ci. Fine. Same way I can find C2, C2 plus E. I'll get what? C0. So now I'll find Ci and C0. Okay. Fine. So now Ci is equal to C1 minus E, C0 is equal to C2 plus E. Even you can find C0 as a total depth. I know C, I need C0, isn't it? This is the C0. I can find total depth. H minus Ci is also what? C0. Both. However you can solve. Okay. However you can find that things. That is a simple mathematics. So here I know C1 as 45.83, E as 8.43. So I got Ci value as 37.4 mm. Same way C0, sorry C2, it is 66.67 plus 8.43. Thus that gives me C0 value 75.1 mm. So I have found Ci and C0. So from the data handbook, so we can find the bending stresses for the inner fiber and outer fiber. So here you can see here page number 159. Here we have the inner fiber maximum tensile stress, outer fiber maximum compressive stresses. So inner fiber sigma is equal to M Ci Ae Ra. So we have found Ci value. So in this C0 by R0, we have found all this E value, Ci value, or all value. So we can find sigma and sigma naught. Okay, fine. So again, I'll write those equations, numbers from the data handbook also. So step 3 or in that step 4, case 3-1, so this is what bending stresses. Bending stress at inner fiber. So bending stress at inner fiber is what? Sigma I is equal to M Ci, it is a positive value, Ae into Ri. This I got from the equation 10.1b, page 159, data handbook. This is very, very important. For every equation where you have got, you have to specify the data handbook. If you have a direct geometrical formula, you need not write. But when you are taking the formula from the data handbook, you have to specify the equation number and the page number. So I know the sigma I. Sigma I, already I have found all these values there. So momentum 9.75 into 10 raised to 6. This is into 37.4 whole divided by 6328.13 into 8.43 into 62.5. Okay. So finally I got sigma I is equal to 109.37 kilo Newton per mm square. Fine, Baba. So this is what the equation we have got for sigma I for the inner fiber. So bending stresses, bending stress at outer fiber, sigma naught is equal to minus, it is a negative sign because it is a compression, M C naught by A E R naught. So this also I'll specify the equation 10.1, it is C, same page number 159 from data hand book. So now if I substitute the values, minus 9.75 10 raised to 6, C naught is 75.1, whole divided by area 6328.13, A is 8.43 into C naught is 75. So now I got the final sigma naught value. Sigma naught is equal to minus 78.43 kilonewton per mm square. So he has said to find the stresses in the crane hook, but what are the stresses? We have found the bending direct stresses and bending stresses. For the direct stresses we have found sigma. Here the bending stresses we have two, one is inner and outer. So now we have to find the resultant stresses. Resultant stresses are nothing but combined stresses, okay? Combine direct and bending stresses gives us what? Resultant stresses. So the last step, step number 5. Step number 5, so resultant stresses. So under that first one, so we have a two, case one is what? Inner fiber, and case two is outer fiber. So combined stresses in the inner and outer, because we have the bending at the inner and outer. So resultant stresses. In inner fiber is sigma I r. I'll call it as, this is the combined stresses. So combined stresses is what? Sigma plus sigma I. So combined stresses, we need to add the direct and bending stresses. So direct for and inner, direct and bending for the inner fiber, because we are considering the resultant stress for the inner fiber. So we have the direct stresses as 14.22 plus 109.37. So finally I got the equation sigma I total R is equal to 123.6 newton per mm square. So this is the combined stresses for the inner fiber or resultant stresses. So resultant stress in outer fiber, sigma naught r is how much? Sigma plus sigma naught, okay? But sigma we know 14.22, but sigma naught we have found what? A negative value. So this becomes minus 78.43. So I will get sigma naught r is equal to minus 64.21 newton per mm square. So these are the stresses what we have found. Even we can find what? Maximum shear stress value, okay? So maximum shear stress is what? So maximum shear stress, we know tau max. Tau max is sigma max by 2. So we have the resultant stresses, isn't it? Sigma IR and sigma IR, sigma naught R. So in this, the maximum value is this 123.6. So this divided by 2 gives you the tau max. So tau max is equal to 123.6 whole divided by 2. This becomes newton per mm square. So this is what? Tau max value. So now we said to find the stress distributions, isn't it? So stress distribution. So if I consider this stress distribution, so we have the trapezoidal shape . So always to draw the stress distribution, we require a neutral axis, okay? So we require a neutral axis. From the neutral axis itself, the stress distribution is going to take place. So if I draw the horizontal line here, from these two edges, if I draw the horizontal line, so here we have a inner fiber and outer fiber. So inner fiber goes for tension and outer fiber will be what? In compression. So how to indicate that? We have the solution itself. So the inner fiber, we sorry here itself. So So combined stress in the resultant stress, inner fiber is 123.5, outer fiber is negative value. So positive value is 123. So here if I draw the positive value, 123.6 Newton per mm square, and this is a minus 64.21 Newton per mm square. So from here I need to draw the parabolic curve. Okay, I'm going to draw the parabolic curve. Now here I am going to draw arrow marks. So because of the positive tension, I'll put the arrow marks on the upper side. So because of the negative, which are in compression, I'll draw the arrow marks in downward direction. Okay, so this indicates that the stress distribution. So this curve is what? Hyperbolic curve. So this is what? Neutral axis. So this part is what? It is in tension. This part is in what? Compression. Okay, so tension at what distance? 123.6. Compression at what distance? Minus 64.21. So this is the problem. What we have, this is the problem on crane hook. Okay, fine. We shall stop here. So from tomorrow, I'll solve one more problem. Okay, thank you.